Good morning all. Welcome to today's class on vector analysis. Today we discuss vector functions. So consider the coordinate system. Suppose you have three axes, x, y and z. Now consider a particle moves in space. Suppose this is the path of a particle moving in space. You consider a point P on the path. So for example, you consider this point P. Corresponding to this point, you have three components. Have an x here, you have a y here, and you have a z here. So that this point will be x, y, z. So you can think as x as a function of time. X is equal to some f of t, y is equal to some g of t, and z is equal to some h of t. Consider OP. We have OP is the position vector of the point P. So that is R of T. We have R of T is equal to X of T I plus Y of T J plus Z of T K. That is R of T equal to F of T I plus G of T J plus H of T K. So we have corresponding to a point T in the time interval. So suppose that T belongs to some interval I of R. I is contained in R. Corresponding to some time interval T, you can define R of T as F of T into I plus G of T into J plus H of T into K. So this is known as a vector function of the real variable T on the interval I. So when a particle moves in space during a time interval I, suppose that at a time t equal to 0 the particle is here, and after certain time, some time t equal to some t1, suppose that the particle is at here. So we are considering the interval 0 t1. So when the particle moves through space during time interval I, we think of the particle's coordinate as a function defined on I. That is, x is equal to f of t, y is equal to g of t, z is equal to h of t. The points x, y, z, that is equal to f of t, g of t, h of t, makes up the curve in space. We usually call it as the path of the particle. And we say that x is equal to f of t, y is equal to g of t, z is equal to h of t, parameterizes the path of the particle, or parameterize the curve. So a curve in space can be represented in two ways. A curve in space defined as x is equal to f of t, y is equal to g of t, and z is equal to h of t. T belongs to I, where I is the time interval. And the vector r of t is equal to f of t I plus g of t j plus h of t k, where t belongs to I, is the vector form of the curve in space. F, g and h are called the component functions of the position vector r of t. R of t defines the particle's position at time t and is given by f of t, g of t, h of t. And the equation r of t equal to f of t I plus g of t j plus h of t k, from a t belongs to I, defines r as a function of the real variable t on the interval I. Now we can define wave vector function. Definition: a vector function or a vector valued function on a domain set D is a rule that assigns a vector in space to each element in D. So you consider a curve in the space. Suppose that this is the curve R of T. So at each point in the time interval T, so you consider a time interval T. Suppose that this is the time interval T, that is I. So if you are considering a T naught here, so this will be vector R of T naught. And when time t equal to 0, if this is a 0 and some, suppose that this is some 1, so at a time t equal to 0, you are defining this vector. This is R of 0. Suppose the particle starts at this point and ends at this point, then at t equal to 1, how this is R of 1. So corresponding to each point t in the domain I, you are defining a vector. So this is an example of a vector function. Now we do some examples. Graph the vector function. We have x of t is equal to cos t, y of t equal to sin t, and z of t equal to t, where t varies over R, set of reals. Now you consider x of t, y of t. So you have x of t square plus y of t square, this is equal to cos square t plus sin square t, that is equal to 1. That is x square plus y square equal to 1 and z equal to t. You know that it is this cylinder. X square plus y square equal to 1 elevated to different heights. T equal to 0. When t equal to 0, you are getting this a circle. When t is equal to some 2 pi, you are getting this circle, etc. When t is equal to minus 2 pi, you are getting a circle here, etc. So you are getting a cylinder as a whole. X square plus y square equal to 1, z equal to t. Now, in our problem, when time t equal to 0, z equal to 0. So you are getting this point. And when time t is equal to pi by 2, you are getting this point. And when time t is equal to pi, you are getting this point. When time t is equal to 2 pi, you are getting this point. That is, you are actually getting a curve on the cylinder like this. So this is the path. R of t is equal to cos t I plus sin t j plus t k. You can see that it is the helix, and at each point on the time interval t, you are defining vectors. So at r equal to 0, you are defining this vector. When time t is equal to pi by 2, you are actually defining this vector. When time t equal to pi, we have this vector. When time t is equal to pi, we have this vector. And when time t is equal to 2 pi, we have this vector. So at each point t in the interval 0 to 2 pi, you are defining vectors in R3. So this actually defines a vector valued function. So as t varies from minus infinity to infinity, you are getting a helix which surrounds the cylinder with infinite length and unit radius. You can plot the helix in GeoGebra as follows. You substitute the equation of the curve as cos t sin t t, t varies from minus 2 pi to 2 pi. So you can see that this is the curve. So when it varies from minus 2 pi to 2 pi, you are getting this curve. When it, suppose it varies from minus 6 pi to 6 pi, see what happens. You can see that This is the curve. So as t varies from minus infinity to infinity, you will get a helix which surrounds the entire y-axis. So when you view the helix from the top, you can see that it will be a circle. So this is the view from the top of the y-axis. Now we plot this curve. R of t is equal to sin 3t cos ti plus sin 3t sin dj plus tk. We can use GeoGebra to plot these equations. So this is the curve. You can see that this is the top view. So this is the curve under consideration. I have plotted this from minus pi to pi, minus 6 pi to pi. Now we plot this curve for which you consider the GeoGebra window. So this is our curve, cos t, x is equal to cos t, y is equal to sin t, z is equal to sin 2t. So you can see that it is this curve. Let's observe from the top. So you can see that it is cos t sin t. This is that curve. So now we plot this curve. R of t is equal to 4 plus sin 20 t cos t I plus 4 plus sin 20 t sin dj plus cos 20 t k. Curve under consideration is this. X is equal to 4 plus sin 20 t cos t. Y is equal to 4 plus sin 20 t sin t, z is equal to cos 20 t. So you can see that this is the curve under consideration. So this is the view from the top. Now we can plot these three helixes. So this is first helix, this is the second one, this is the third one. So we can plot these three helixes now. This is the first case, cos t sin dt. Now we plot the second curve, cos t sin t 0.3t. So we are getting, this is your new helix. From the top again it is a circle, and now You can plot the third one. This cos 5t sin 5t t. See, observe what happens. Cos 5t sin 5t t. This is your new curve. And suppose again you are giving 0.3t. See what happens. So you're getting a helix like this. See, observe the change in the coefficient of t and what the corresponding change in the curve. So it is 0.3t, 0.03t. So we're getting almost a cylinder. Okay, that's all for the day. Have a nice day.